students, in today's video we are going to discuss the lines from 115 onwards of Browning's famous dramatic monologue Andrea del Sarto. Still, what an arm, and I could alter it, but all the play, the inside and the stretch, out of me, and wherefore out? Had you enjoined them on me, given me soul, we might have risen to Raphael, I and you. As I had told you people in my previous video, that Andrea is lamenting over the fact that although he is superior as far as painting, the art of painting is concerned, he is far much ahead than other common painters, yet he lacks the divine inspiration which is there, which is available to other painters. He is lacking in that. So, keeping in mind that fact, when he looks at the painting which I had mentioned in the previous video, one drawn by Michelangelo, he had pointed out that there is error in the arm of that painting. So the painter in his soul, he again and again just wants to correct that thing. See, this is human tendency. If we are aware of something and if we have the capacity to do something, and if we find an error done by someone else in that particular field, we tend to correct it immediately. It's human tendency. So he himself, Andrea is no exception here. He also is a good painter. So when he looks at the slight error in the painting of Michelangelo, he again and again just gets inspired to correct that. So again he is saying, still what an arm, and I could alter it. He says, see, though the painting is good, it is beautiful to look at, but what an arm, there is error in this arm, and I could alter it, and I can very well correct it. But all the play, the insight and the stretch, out of me, wherefore out? But he is, lacking in the willpower to do so. Why? He says, whatever observation, power of observation I have, or whatever the width of vision I have, it's at present I am feeling quite out of place. I don't want these things with me. And he himself raises the question. He says, why I am shunning these things? Why far out? There is a particular reason behind it. He knows his capabilities. He knows his, powers that he has as a painter. But at the present juncture, he does not want any of that. And he says, and he gives you the reason for that. He says, had you enjoined them on me, given me soul, we might have risen to Raphael, I and you. He puts the blame on Lucrezia. He says, oh Lucrezia, had you, along with my painting capabilities, had you also joined me, that means had you given me moral support, had you given me the soul, soul here stands for the moral support, had you given me the moral support, we could have been able to achieve far much popularity than Raphael, or far much excellence than Raphael, I and you. He says, oh Lucrezia, had you supported me, I have all the capabilities, I have all the qualities which are required for a person to be called as a great painter. I have that. I am not lacking in any sort of craftsmanship, but I am lacking in the moral, force. And you are the reason for that. Had you given me moral support, we could have worked wonders. I could have achieved the highest point in the fame and popularity achieved by a painter. Nay, love, you did give all I asked, I think. Suddenly he changes his tone, and what might be the reason, we can guess. See, he is so much devoted towards his wife that he cannot tolerate even a slight frown on the face of his beloved. So naturally, when he started blaming his wife, the wife might have frowned. There might have a frown on her face, on her forehead. Might have been some indication that she is not liking the way he is accusing her. So her facial features might have changed. And when Indriya saw to that, he immediately just took an apologetic stand and he said, "Nay, love, you did give all I asked." I think he says, "Oh love, oh Lucrezia, you did give all I asked. You definitely gave me whatever I asked from me. I asked from you. I think more than I merit." He even goes on to the extent of saying that even you have given me so much as I was not, you can say, entitled to. You have given me more than my actual merit. Yes, by many times. And he says, "Yeah, I am quite sure of this thing that you have given me, you have conferred upon me so much that I actually did not deserve. But had you, with the same perfect brow and perfect eyes and more than perfect mouth and the low voice my soul hears as a bird, the fowler's pipe and follows to the snare, had you with these the same but brought a mind." But still there is somehow, there is a sense of regret in him. And he says, "Although you gave me whatever I asked from you, but even then I feel that the perfection that is there in your beauty, the perfection in your eyebrows, the perfection in your eyes, the perfection in your mouth, and your beautiful voice, which has captured my soul like a bird is captured by the fowler, by the music of the fowler's pipe. Whenever the fowler plays on his pipe, the bird gets ensnared. Just you can say, listening to the sweet voice, it forgets the trap and it gets ensnared. In the same way, my soul got entrapped by your beauty. Had along with your beauty, you had given me your brain, you had given me your mind, you had given me your moral support, we could have done wonders." So throughout the paragraph, we can say that he is hanging in between blaming and praising his wife. He says, "Even I have the capability to surpass others. I have everything what is required from a great painter. I know I have all those things with me. But still, these things are of no interest to me, or they are not paying me back, because along with that, I am lacking in that driving force, in that moral support which a companion could give." Lucrezia never supported her husband. She was always concerned with the monetary benefit only. And we all know that poets and artists and painters, they are the persons who have, you can say, very sensitive nature, and they get very much affected by the praise or the blame of their near and dear ones. So Lucrezia never supported morally her husband. So that's what, and Indriya knew this fact very well. So he says, "Along with whatever you gave me your beauty, you gave me your youth, but along with that, had you given me your moral support, I could have given you, you can say, the greatest name and fame. I could have achieved the greatest name and fame, and that to my own satisfaction." Today he is famous, but he is not satisfied with his fame. Had Lucrezia supported him, he could have achieved fame, which would have brought satisfaction even to him. So that's all for today.